Hey everybody, okay, I'm gonna go ahead and walk you through how to make the repeat tile in Illustrator. This is for artwork to be printed on fabric, like a textile design of some sort. However you do your artwork, you do need to also create a tile that, you know, falls in repeat, that can be printed again and again and again on fabric. You need your edges to line up, all that good stuff. What I don't want to see from students in this class is if they take an object such as this flower and they call this their repeat tile. This is what I've been calling a checkerboard repeat, and it's not very sophisticated. It's overly simple. I think anyone can do it. You don't need a class to learn how to do that. Instead, you're going to make a more intricate repeat that has more flow. It's more organic. Really, so that when your repeat tile is repeated a bunch of times in like 1 yard of fabric, the viewer, it's not obvious where the repeat tile is. Instead, the viewer can enjoy your artwork and the flow of the artwork. So that's what we're really going for. So fair warning, don't submit this. Students always do. It's not gonna get the best grade because I already know you can do that. I wanna challenge you to something else. Okay, so by now you should have drawn a minimum of 6 elements. You may find that you need to draw a few more. That's absolutely okay as well. And you're just gonna start placing these elements, you know, just on your artboard. I'm gonna hold down Option to make a copy. There we go. And I also recommend spinning them. You don't wanna get stuck with a print that is directional, meaning there's a top and a bottom. Because if that happens, it's just gonna cost more to make garments. You're gonna not have as high of a yield. You'll have more wasted fabric because all your patterns have to be printed in a certain direction. So you can actually save a lot of money and a lot of fabric if your print is directional. There'll be less fabric waste, which is good for the environment, right? Okay. So anyways, I'm just kind of taking these elements. I'm just placing them. And then another thing to kind of think about is how much of the background do you want to see? Do you like this, you know, kind of red, orange, negative space? Or do you think it would look better if there was less of it? So you get to decide that. Another little thing too is if you want to change layers, a quick way is to just hit Command X, Command F to paste on the front layer. If you're trying to get it in between things, like, let's see, or maybe for some reason I want this leaf above the yellow flower but below this like sunflower thing or whatever, daisy, I don't know what it is. I can say Command X, so it's on my clipboard, and then I could hold the top flower and I could say Command B for like behind. I'm going to say Command X. Or I could click the bottom flower and say Command F for front. So that's just a quick way to kind of do some layering. I know a lot of students like to go object, arrange, and they play with all this, but that can just take a little bit longer. Or you can always open up your layers palette too. I'm gonna go to window, layers, and you can click drag and drop this way. Whatever's selected, there'll be like a little blue dot over on the right hand. There it is. I mean, I have a lot of layers right now, so you can just click drag and move to where you want. But I think the best way is Command X. Command F for front, Command B for back. Okay, so anyways, so part of this design challenge is like, how do I arrange these elements so that they feel balanced and it's a nice composition and it has good flow? That's gonna be something for you to spend a little time on to think about. Okay, once you think you're pretty good, we can go ahead and start working on the repeat tile. Right now, this would actually not be a great repeat tile because we're gonna have a solid background color here, red on the left and right side and on the top and bottom. So it'll get that checkerboard thing that I don't really like. So I'm gonna demo that right now. So window, open up your swatches, make sure they're open if they're not already. And you're gonna click your artwork, click drag and drop into swatches. If you're having any issues with this, there's a couple troubleshooting things we can go through. One, make sure you're not selecting a guideline because it can't make a repeat of guides. Two, make sure that all of your fill colors and stroke colors are just a solid color and not a pattern swatch because it can't make a swatch of a pattern swatch. So that happens to students a lot. If it's happening to you, reach out and let me know. Okay, but this time it worked. It was really easy. I click, drag, and drop. Another thing that students have issue is when they try to click, drag, and drop it, is sometimes they don't grab the object. They grab like the white background and they like, it's not moving. So just common student issues you might run into. But hopefully you guys can get it in here. Okay, so let's see what it looks like. Let's say I open up a yard of fabric. Go to the fabric store. Yard of fabric is, oops, I'm in millimeters. Let's change. I'm going to say cancel. I don't know how much a yard of fabric is in millimeters. I don't feel like figuring it out. File, oh, hold on a second. Cancel, file, document, setup. There we are. Let's change our units to inches. That's more my speed. Okay, so click one time. 36 inches is in 1 yard. And then, you know what? Sometimes your fabric is like 45 inches wide. Then 36 inches long is a yard. Okay. So here's a big yard of fabric. What is our artwork going to look like? I'm going to pick the fill, and I'm going to fill it with a new swatch we just made. I'm going to attempt to. There we are. Okay, so it's very checkerboard, right? It's pretty obvious where the repeat is. We have the solid backgrounds. We need to get rid of that. That's the big challenge for this assignment. So Illustrator's made it easy. They have a newish tool. So all we have to do actually is go up to... window and pattern options. Yay. Okay, so you want to make sure that just a solid square with your print is selected. Don't be confused. Don't be selecting your actual vector artwork. The only thing that's really vector right here are these like four corners of this square. So that's what should be selected with your black arrow. And it should have the print inside of it, okay? Then all you have to do is double click this swatch. Click, click. Cool. So now I can like move stuff around. So maybe I'll hold option and I'll add a new one. I'm gonna add it right on that line. And it's gonna make one on the top and the bottom. Okay, so now unfortunately it looks like my background is kind of in the way. I'm gonna say Command X. Command B, just to make sure it's on the bottom. Not sure. I'm surprised that this flower isn't showing up. I'll deal with that later. Yeah, it kind of gets cut off. Odd. Oh, no. Huh, that's strange. Okay, it's not supposed to do that. So you know what? Maybe for now I get rid of this background. I'm not sure. Okay, well, this is not a good example. I'm going to delete that guy. Okay. Let's try if I do it over here. So you know what I think I'm going to do? It's not lining up like I was expecting it to. So I'm going to delete this background. There we go. I think just having the background was like messing with it. Okay, we can add the background later. No big deal. Okay, so now I'm going to go ahead and move these elements. I'm going to fill in this like empty white space that we have, right? Which is nice. So this is a much easier way for a designer to figure out how to do their pattern repeat, because now you're not thinking about the repeat. You're just looking at your yard of fabric and you're kind of just coloring in the empty spaces, which is nice. Okay, I'll grab this leaf, hold shift. Okay. Maybe I'll do another one here. And again, don't forget, we want to toss this guy. Oh, he wasn't in my main square. I gotta get him in my main square. There we go. Okay, what else should I do? What about this little guy? Maybe up here. Okay, it's looking better. And again, you can really spend a lot of time just kind of thinking about the overall like composition. Is the negative space looking good? Does it feel balanced? You know, do I have too many of the same kind of flowers next to each other? Can spend a lot of time doing all of that. I'm kind of going fast just to kind of finish it up. Okay, so I'm getting happier. I think there's still some empty spots. Honestly, I kind of want to play with it a little bit more. But we're getting somewhere, maybe right here. Anyways, I really filled it up. You might actually like your negative space and have more spacing, that's okay. But anyways, if you were to look at this 1 yard of fabric, it's kind of hard to tell where the repeat starts and stops. I'm gonna finish, so I'm gonna double click to get out. Okay, there we go. So I clicked on the outside. Wow, that looks cool. I really like it. I am kind of like worried that, oh, I feel like this is kind of stripey. Do you see that little negative space here? It feels a little stripey when I'm standing away and looking at the yard of fabric. So I might try to go in and fix that. So you can kind of make all those tweaks, but you want, you know, the yard of fabric to look good, because what if you're gonna cut like a big dress out of this? You don't want it to be like chunky square shapes of artwork. You really want it to like look good together. So, okay, so this is good. So you're gonna turn in like a JPEG or screenshot of what like 1 yard of fabric would look like with your repeat tile. And then you're also gonna turn in your actual tile that you would send to a factory or upload it on all these different websites to make your own fabric. So you need that repeat tile. So how do we prep that repeat tile? Okay, so it's a much easier way now. We can actually probably, well, delete that. But again, oh yes, I need my background, I forgot. So I'm gonna click drag and pull out the swatch back to Illustrator. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in here. There is a clear box. Clear box, what? Do you guys see this like rectangle shape? It's a vectorized box. The stroke color is clear and the background and the fill color is clear. So I gotta figure out how do I select it. I'm gonna hit the letter A and I'm gonna grab it. Yep, there's no fill, no stroke. It also happens to be on the very bottom layer. This is like the computer code that works with Illustrator that tells Illustrator how to make a repeat in the swatches. So even though there's elements here on the outside, they're getting deleted when Illustrator puts it in the swatch palette. So what you need to do is take this clear box, turn it into a clipping mask, okay? So I'm gonna go ahead, maybe switch to the black arrow. I'm gonna say Command C to copy it. I'm gonna deselect. Then I'm gonna say Command F. So it pastes it on the very top layer. Uh-oh, I only had part of my box selected. So I'm gonna say delete, I'm gonna try to grab it again. This time I'll use the black arrow. Selected the whole thing. I'm gonna double click, click, click. So it temporarily will ungroup it. And then, okay, so now I was able to grab it with the black arrow. That's better. Command C to copy. I'm gonna get out of this group by double clicking the background. Click, click. Command F. So it pastes that square on the top layer, which we can use to make a clipping mask, which maybe you guys remember from your inspiration boards. So I'm gonna go ahead and select all of it. Command 7, or you go object clipping mask make. This is your repeat tile. So watch, I'm gonna make a repeat of it. I'm gonna try to line it up. And I'm holding shift so I don't accidentally drop it. You know what, I could even use the align tool. Let's do that. Window, align. I'll select both of these, then I'll pick this one as the starter. And we could say distribute space 0 inches. There we go. And look at that, the artwork matches perfectly. I don't even know where it starts and stops, this repeat tile. There it goes, right here. Perfect, that's what you want. Same with the top and bottom. Let's try test it out, right? Cool, looks like it's lined up perfectly. It's not off at all. So that means this is your awesome repeat tile. I can delete all of these. You can send this tile to the factory and they can make fabric for you. That's what we're trying to do. I did kind of glance over the background. We never added that background. So let's go back and do that right now. So I'm gonna double click this guy. Click, click. That kind of ungroups it so I can kind of get in. And I'm gonna, so we have two objects in this group and maybe looking at our layers could be kind of helpful. Let's see here. So see how it thinks we have two objects? We have all of our artwork grouped together, and then we have our clear clipping mask that we pasted on the top layer. I actually wanna get into the artwork, so I'm gonna do another double click so I can get into this business. Click, click. And then I'm gonna look for that clear box again. Oh, let's see here, hopefully I selected it. Yes, see that green thing? That means I selected it, it looks clear. I have the clear box on the very bottom layer. So I'm gonna keep it, the clear box, I'm just gonna say copy. And while it's still selected, I'll hit Command F to paste right on top of it. So let's see if that worked. Do you see that? So now that was my clear box, this bottom one, but I pasted a new one right on top of it. So it's still below all of my other artwork. And I'm gonna go ahead and fill in that box to not be clear anymore and give it my background color. And there we go. I can double click to get out of this. And now my repeat swatch has that background color. Now, because I still have that clear box on the bottom layer, I can actually put this back into the swatch palette. So let's do that. Let's see if I can figure out where my swatches went. I don't know where my swatches went, so I'll just go window, and oh, they're somewhere. Here they are. Click, drag, drop. Let's see here. And let's fill in my yard of fabric here with the new one I just made. There you go. So let me see if I zoom in. Yeah, still in repeat, and I got my background color. I just want to warn you, some beginners, they'll accidentally delete that bottom clear box. And again, that's the computer code that tells Illustrator like how to repeat your swatch. So you want to make sure that clear box is on the bottom layer and it's in the right position. But anyways, it's pretty easy with their tool. Go ahead, give it a shot. Don't forget, you're going to turn in, I want to see a PNG of the actual tile and a PNG of what it looks like in a yard of fabric. And I want you to turn in your AI file so I can go in and inspect it. So reach out if you guys have any questions, and looking forward to seeing your artwork.